Okay, I got the deck back on the RK24. I drove it up over top of it. The deck, you know, it's you kind of move it around. I use a shovel to put underneath the deck, kind of lift it up a little bit to get the pins lined up on it. And also they call it the quick connect front piece. Let me show you the pins here real quick. And the pins are right here. You can see the pins. They're down here on the bottom where the deck is right here. It's got a key ring here. You know, you take the key ring, you twist it out, and then you pop that pin out of there. Now, in order to get the frame part up here connected, you know, with the pin, of course you have to move your deck around just a little bit, try to lift it up, and that's the hardest thing. I just stick something underneath the deck and it kind of helps me move the deck around underneath. It's nice you can drive up top of them because you don't have to pull this deck out and pull it underneath the tractor. But, you know, there's still other things you have to do to put this deck on, which I don't mind for the price that pay for this machine. I don't mind spending a little bit extra time to hook up attachments and stuff on it. The dry shaft is a little tricky. Let's see if I can get down here. I got a piece of styrofoam down here. Something laying on the ground that's wet today. The ground is. But let me see. You can see the dry shaft. The dry shaft's got a quick connect on it. Right here. Let me try not to move it around too much for you. It's got a quick connect. See this ring here? You pull the ring back and you can slide this off. Now, the other thing I see about that is you got to learn how, of course, you have to have patience to line these shafts up. Okay, and then once you learn how to do that, it gets easier and easier. I've done this about four times so far, to try to figure it out, and now it's getting easier and easier. And I can actually put this dry shaft on with one hand. Now taking it off, you know, you just pull back on it, and then you shove the dry shaft back, and it pops right off. But the thing is, you know, with the dry shaft, it doesn't bother me. It might bother some people that you have to crawl underneath of this and connect that. Now, the way these things are, while I'm under here, you have a rod right here, and it's connected back here onto the lift. And these rods actually, you know, go up here and hook onto your frame, the frame that comes with the deck, not the tractor frame itself. And then when you do the hydraulics and you pick it up, it actually pulls it up from the back here. Let me get up here. Okay, sorry about that moving around. Trying to hold that. So when you get your deck, you get a bracket, and this is one of the brackets right here. What's wrong with that thing? Here's one of the brackets that come with it, and it sits on the back of these two arms here for your hydraulic. And then you can see the spring right there. I'm pointing at the spring. And that spring and that shaft goes all the way up and connects to the deck. And you can actually take these off very quickly too. It's got a quick pin right here, quick connect pin. And I had to go back in and get a couple washers. I wanted to put a couple of washers in there. I don't know if that was the way it was supposed to be or what, but they originally came with, I think, one washer. I'm not for sure, but I thought maybe we didn't have all the washers. It don't seem like it has, you know, too much a difference on if it was one washer or it was four. But like I said, the bracket goes on here, so when this when you lift the back here, it actually pulls on these springs. And then of course you got one on this side here too that does, you know, the exact same thing. And that's how you lift your lift the deck up. I'm gonna move this stuff out of the road. Like I said, the deck to me, I think the deck's really, really well made. It's got a heavy, very heavy gauge steel in it. But it takes a little bit of time to put these on. It's just not how they show you. You drive up over it and bang, there you go. Look, it takes seconds to put the pins in. I know there's only two pins and then your quick connect, they call it in front. But there's still some effort to it. Don't get me wrong on it. As you can see here in the front, let me see if I can get around this other side and I'll show you the quick connect. Okay, And this is the one they were talking about, how you'd actually pull this lever or pin, you want to call it, and then once you pull this back toward us, and then you press down on this here, and you kind of twist it, and this whole section here, all the way back to where the deck is itself. Let me see if I can get back here a little bit. Back here, it's it just kind of sets there on the front of the deck, and by pulling the lever and putting the pressure on the front, it helps you. Then when you pick up the deck, it puts the pressure back onto that. Now, if you look over here, this little pin here, of course, when I first put it together, I said this, the frame all came together because it was a dropped off of a package deal they had in there, and somebody didn't want the mower deck, and so they dropped it off, and the frame was already put together. This is called the frame here, okay? And then there's actually like one, I think there was two. No, yeah, because there's one, two. Let me see if I can show you. There's one, two, and then there's one up under here. So it's three bolts here, and then if you come back here, I don't know if we can see. Let's see if I can see this. The bolts back here I stuck on. Yeah, you can see them. There's three bolts right there. One, and then there's two right here, and three. And it's on both sides like that. And then I call this, of course, this is like the frame. Okay, now let's get back to this piece here for a second. And I wanted to explain to you, this is your adjustment here. Okay, lift your deck up, put something underneath the wheels or whatever, because these are actually floaters. To me, they're floaters. And the wheel should be at least a half inch or so off the ground. Of course, it tells you. We're moving this pin in different spots. Because if you look behind here, which I can't take it off right now, there's a bunch of holes drilled in this piece right here. And then, of course, that's adjustment for each, you know, level, wherever you want to adjust. If you want to mow your grass to, say, an inch high or an inch and a half high, that's basically how you do that right there. Okay, and then of course your wheels, you set your wheels, like I said, they should be off the ground. Okay, of course I talked to my brother, and he's the one that kind of explains to me, because he set these up before. And the only thing I'm displeased was like I said, the decks didn't have grease fittings at them, which I'm going to ask them up there and see later if I can't get the spindles, maybe some new spindles, and stick some grease fittings in. Now, when I purchased the deck, one of the tractors up there, I guess they brought back a mower deck, and one of the wheels caught the deck and pulled the deck up. And me and my wife, we were both talking about, you know, how we're going to stop that problem that this guy told me. He said, be careful when you turn the wheels real sharp. I'll show you. And let's see if you can see that. I don't know if you can see that or not, but right in here, there's a buff mark, okay? And then when the tires would turn real sharp, that would catch that deck. And I kept watching. I'm like, come on, there's got to be a way to fix this thing. You know, this is crazy. And when at the dealership, they told me at the dealership that to be careful when you turn because it's catching. And we looked around. I said, come on, man. I did all this adjustment, get this thing, you know, try to get it the best I can for the mowing season, which, like I said, there's no grass yet high enough to mow. And I started looking down here in the front, okay? And if you look in the front of the wheels here, they do this on purpose, actually. Let's see if I get my hand out of the road. There's an adjustment right here, okay? There's one on both sides like that. Okay, and you can adjust these things in or out. And what it does, it actually comes over here when you turn the wheel, and it come over and hits the axle itself. Now, that keeps the wheel from turning so far, which I thought that was okay there. Let me go over here on this side. I'll show you there's one just like it over here on this side. And yeah, it's right here. There's another one right here. And like I said, you know, that I'd have to adjust these back. I think this one's adjusted out a little bit further than that one is over there. Let me see my head out of it. But what I did, I just adjusted these out so when you crank the wheel so far, it's gonna stop on the frame or not the frame, it'll stop on this axle here and keep the tire on that side from hitting that deck. So it, what it does is actually just keeps the machine from turning so much. So if you happen to turn it that way and you're on a little bit of a bind, it's not going to grab a hold of that deck and pick that deck up and run that deck. So he said there's some adjustments to lift it up and down, and it takes a little bit of time. I'm for sure once you get it, you know, all adjusted and everything. Like I said, I'm not going to run mine with a bucket, so I'm just right now just I stuck the deck on, let you guys see. And appreciate you guys watching and everything, and let me know what your comments is, and thanks for watching.